Hey guys, Level Cap here, and Battlefield 5 and even the future of the entire franchise may be in a dire state. A few days ago, DICE let us know what's going on with the next update for Battlefield 5. Basically, they are planning to release a patch in April, but they're going to have to push it back to May because of the health crisis going on right now. It's disappointing news for sure, and with a game that's already had historically slow updates and a lack of content, an even bigger slowdown feels like it could be the first nail in the coffin. But there's a few silver linings. Apparently, DICE are working on some form of a team balancer. Since launch, Battlefield 5 had no automated system for shuffling players around to even out matches. If a player leaves a game, their slot is filled by whoever joins the server next. The problem is, sometimes no one joins that specific server, so if a bunch of players leave, you can end up with one team being really full while the other is barely half full. It can also be a rough experience for players joining servers as they often end up on a losing team. Plus, there doesn't seem to be any sort of matchmaking based on skill. Score-based matchmaking or skill-based matchmaking has become a hot topic lately, thanks in large part to Call of Duty Modern Warfare. Right now, it's basically impossible to avoid drawing comparisons between Battlefield 5 and Modern Warfare. Gameplay-wise, yes, they're radically different games, but they both have large-scale infantry combat modes. That's Battlefield 5's main draw, and Modern Warfare's Ground War mode is pretty well populated despite how chaotic the gameplay is. Both games have Battle Royale modes that are actually really solid, but of course Battlefield 5's Firestorm is effectively dead, while Modern Warfare's Warzone launched as a free-to-play standalone game that has well over 30 million players at this point. In a lot of ways, it feels like Call of Duty is riding higher than it ever has before, while Battlefield has fallen to its lowest point ever in terms of popularity. You'd be hard-pressed to find a gaming news site covering Battlefield 5 anymore. I couldn't even find an article talking about the potential team balancer coming to the game. Meanwhile, if a dev at Infinity Ward tweets about anything, it pretty much makes headlines. Modern Warfare has become a juggernaut title. Millions upon millions of people are playing it, and despite the ongoing health crisis, Infinity Ward have been able to pump out content for the game non-stop. Battlefield 5, on the other hand, is the most polarizing and anemic games ever in the franchise. At this point, about 16 months into the game's life cycle, Battlefield 4 even had gotten a CTE program that totally reworked the game's networking. With the netcode fix, DICE were dropping massive expansions every few months along with some offbeat community maps. And looking back now at Battlefield 4, everyone regards it as a content-packed standout of the franchise. Likewise with Battlefield 1, the game's first months could have been seen as a bit rough, but many players still prefer its visuals and general design to Battlefield 5. They're fundamentally very different games, with Battlefield 1 being very casual and approachable, while Battlefield 5 is more hardcore and tough to digest. But despite how different they are, many players view Battlefield 1 as a superior title because it got a wealth of content and is a polished, immersive experience that did what it set out to do. Basically, DICE have a track record of releasing games in a rough state and winning over players with long-term support and big content drops. That has not been the case with Battlefield 5, though. 16 months into Battlefield 5's life cycle, and we're still waiting for the game to be polished up. We're still waiting for the most iconic battles of World War II, like D-Day, Battle of the Bulge, the Eastern Front, and more, if they're even ever coming. We're nearly 4 months into the new year, and DICE still hasn't given us any indication of what's on the roadmap for the rest of the year. The Pacific content launched last December, and it's basically the only thing holding players' attention at this point. It does make you wonder, is Battlefield 5's decline unique to itself, or is it a symptom of the changing landscape of gaming? I certainly don't hold anything against DICE for delaying the next major update to May. Despite the Swedish government's voluntary orders to stay at home during the crisis, DICE took the initiative and set all their employees up to work from home without a gap in pay for a single employee. It's impressive and inspiring to see how DICE has handled the situation, and it is commendable as a corporate policy for sure. The problem is, this commendable action is affecting a game that was already on shaky ground at best. It's been 16 months and the light is still at the far end of the tunnel for Battlefield 5. My question is, does Battlefield 5 actually have a future? Will it ever be the well-polished, content-rich experience past Battlefield titles eventually became? Or will it just be stuck in this weird limbo state where all of the problems like janky animations, busted assignment systems, poor vehicle mechanics, and more are painfully obvious but never really get addressed? And even if DICE are able to right the ship and realize Battlefield 5's full potential, will that actually be enough to compete in today's gaming landscape? Even when looking at the polished Battlefield 1, it's clear that the limited features and progression system just aren't up to par with today's expected content. Activision are on a roll with Modern Warfare, and they're likely releasing a full remaster of Modern Warfare 2's campaign tomorrow. Apex Legends is knee-deep in a content-rich season that's excited the player base and helped the game grow insanely well. Escape from Tarkov blew up overnight and is now one of the de facto shooters played on Twitch. CSGO is 8 years old and just broke 1 million concurrent players for the first time ever. Riot are on the cusp of dropping their own CSGO and Overwatch mashup game, Valorant. There's just so much competition from so many published titles that have a ton of content, it really begs the question, what will DICE do next, or what can they even do next? To me, it feels kind of like Battlefield 5 is a bit of a lost cause. The amount of redesign, refinement, and new content needed to make Battlefield 5 an incredible title just seems like an insurmountable amount of work. And even then, my confidence in DICE's ability to do it right is at an all-time low. The Pacific update proved that Battlefield 5 can pull players back in and get them excited. But every time DICE manages to hit a high note with this game, they pull the rug right out from under us. EA Play got us excited for all sorts of new content, only for it to turn into a drip feed of okay maps and buggy updates. Firestorm was an incredibly fun and engaging battle royale mode that launched behind a $60 paywall for a game that had really bad public image. Now it's dead in the water, with DICE halting work on the mode probably forever. It was without a doubt a slam dunk for DICE. They delivered some iconic locations in an update that made positive changes to the game. It finally felt good to play. But then they released the 5.2 weapon balance update that broke the established TTK we've had since launch. I don't think I've ever seen such uniform and vocal outrage from the Battlefield community before. Almost overnight, DICE threw away all the good faith they had just spent a year building with a boneheaded update that nobody asked for, and they took 3 months to fix. Ultimately, I think what's happening here is that the benchmark for quality in games has gotten so much higher than it used to be, and DICE's efforts just aren't going to be competitive in today's market. Live service titles like Fortnite, Overwatch, CSGO, and Rainbow Six Siege have come to define what post-launch support for a game should look like. The standard that DICE's Battlefield team has demonstrated they're capable of achieving just isn't enough anymore to compete with these titles. It's certainly not enough to drip feed a handful of maps over the course of a year. It's definitely not enough to drop a massively ambitious new game that takes a year to feel like it's even getting polished, and it's not going to be enough to have several month-long gaps between major updates. And despite all the doom and gloom in this video, I do want Battlefield 5 to succeed. I'm a Battlefield player at heart. This entire channel was built upon the Battlefield franchise, and I certainly want the best for it. Generally speaking, I think that's what most players want from DICE. The question is, can they deliver? And if they do, at this point, will it even be enough? The gaming industry has become so much more competitive and even saturated over the past few years that I just don't think there's room for another disaster launch like Battlefield 5 with DICE's next Battlefield title. Players expect big name titles to be polished on release, and really there's only so much more room for big titles to succeed given just how hard they're fighting each other for our attention. The next Battlefield title has little room for error, and given DICE's track record, it seems unlikely that they'll launch a title that checks all the boxes and isn't riddled with bugs. Not only that, the other side of the issue is content. Every game these days is getting new maps, modes, weapons, cosmetics, or something like that added on a nearly weekly basis. And DICE certainly hasn't evolved to meet these demands. The space between content drops for Battlefield has always been measured in months, but it's been much more painful with Battlefield 5 because the game desperately needed something to distract us from its problems. On a personal level, it's very difficult to see any sort of successful future for Battlefield 5 at this point, or people remembering the game overall fondly. It's probably going to go down as one of the worst titles in the Battlefield franchise. Does that mean it will be the end of the franchise? Well, Battlefield 6, or the next Battlefield game, really needs to hit a home run. Many franchises have shown that they can weather a bad title here or there, but with the extreme slope of Battlefield 5 right now and the extreme competitive nature of the overall market, it's hard to see how they can weather another failure like Battlefield 5. Hopefully, the next game will be a massive home run for the franchise, and we can stop worrying about the future of this franchise in general. As always, guys, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know what you think about the state of Battlefield 5. Let me know in the comments down below, and I'll see you next time. This is Level Cap signing off.